Yo, what it do, YouTube? It's me, Can't Stop a Money, and we are back inside the Hyperbolic Reaction Chamber, and this is another reaction to The Seven Deadly Sins. Yes, guys, The Seven Deadly Sins, Season 2, Episode 12, or if you want to put it all together, Episode 36. All right, so happy Monday to you all. I know most of y'all hate Mondays. Let's see if we can brighten up. With a smile on y'all's face, yes, we're back with Seven Deadly Sins, the Seven Deadly Sins. All right, guys. So, Meliodas got his power back. Teleported to the Ten Commandments. Gave Gollum the blues. Gave him the business. Gave him gave everybody a nice little warning. To say, hey, we're coming for y'all. Yes. Yes, so awesome. It was hype. I can't wait to see more of this, guys. Yes. All right. So, and one more thing. Rest in peace, Zavago. Yes, rest in peace, Zavago. That was emotional. And that was just, that hit me in the feels, guys. So, yes, let's go ahead and get into this. As you guys know, this is the redirect video. There will be links in the description below to the uncut reaction. Yes, to Google Drive, BitChute, possibly Mega as well. Whichever one works out for you guys. Let's keep going on this train. Let's keep going. Yes. Without further ado, the video will be played right here in this corner. Come back and see my final thoughts, guys. This is The Seven Deadly Sins, Season 2, Episode 12. Right now. Okay, guys. That was Episode 12 of Season 2 of The Seven Deadly Sins. This episode got a lot of information. And a lot of holy craps. Oh my god. Okay. For starters. Hawk's little transformation thing. He went through. Arthur with something on his head that won't come off. Everybody else that went up. Big guy. Grimmore with. This. This child, for some reason, how did he get the child? The other girl, not Jenna, but the other one, I forgot her name momentarily, brain went flat. But, she didn't put a seed in there for Elizabeth to grow because she didn't want her to pass the trial because, that'll mean she'll want to accompany Meliodas on the journey, and if Elizabeth, something happens to Elizabeth, Meliodas would just, once again, Meliodas would lose his shit, go crazy, and possibly throw his life away, just like how it was for the Elizabeth back in the day. And I completely understand that, I really do. She's doing this to protect Meliodas and, protect Elizabeth as well, because she knows that, how Meliodas cares about this Elizabeth. And yes, like I said in the middle of the video, I caught that shit. It's pretty much obvious, but I caught it a couple days ago. This Elizabeth we know, white hair, is the reincarnation of the old Elizabeth. Yes, with the red hair. Yes, caught that. All right. That's that. That was crazy. Now we have the dead getting resurrected. One of the Ten Commandments. The girl with the summon ring. I gotta remember her name. I remember these names, guys. Next time, yeah, her reviving, digging up these souls and going back to bodies, and they're just bad. They're evil. Just souls. Forgotten souls that people may have forgotten about, and they have a grudge against them and everything. Like that explains the guy that hates women. Him right there. Now, Elaine. Oh my god, they did not just go that far. Elaine's soul is resurrected to the body. It's not her. It's a dark her. Which, it changed her white pure dress to dark evil. She's jealous. Well, not jealous. She's angry against everybody that spent time with Bond. All of that. And she just wants Bond. Now, Bond and her are together at the end kissing. And it's like, it's good and bad because that's what Bond always wanted her to be resurrected. Bond wants her to be resurrected so bad, no matter how. just wants to be resurrected. But it's bad because she's not, it's not the Elaine that he knew. It's not the good Elaine that he knew. And it's like, is he going to be blinded by the fact that that's his love right there and just won't do anything no matter how bad she is? Or will he actually just have to kill her with his own hands? And I can only imagine how much sorrow that's going to put on him. That's going to be very sad. I don't know how this is going to turn out. It's so fucking awesome. I'm all over the place. Oh my God, guys. We're going to have another one tomorrow. What you guys thought about that? Let me know in the comment section. This shit is getting so fucking... It's all right. It's been good. This shit's getting... I don't know. It's words that can't... I can't describe it. It's words I can't describe. This shit is just... It's on a whole nother level. And yes, and also stated, Meliodas' power level, 32,000. But Meliodas also said, it's Kanner, the last sin, is even stronger than him. It's stronger than that. So you're telling me this guy's probably like, how strong is it? How strong? I can't even put a number on it. Holy shit, you're telling me that even throughout the whole power-up that Meliodas had, or him receiving his power back, you telling me Iskander is stronger than that? There's a reason why we haven't seen him yet. He's the last sin. There's a reason why we haven't seen him yet, guys. I cannot fucking wait. Yes, alright, so, you guys like this, leave a like, comment, subscribe if you're new, and I'll be sure to see you all in my next one. Sayonara.